Michael Dean Tate raped a woman back in 1978. He wasn't charged with the crime until 2019.
He was sentenced in Kenton County. Last year, he admitted to raping several women to Boone County detectives. Those investigators think it went even further. Alexa Helwig explains.
It was October 1st, 1978. A woman called Park Hills police telling them she had been kidnapped and raped. Decades later, Detective Coy Cox was investigating an unsolved homicide in Boone County.
It had a lot of similarities to the case in Park Hills, along with three or four other ones that happened within like a 24-month time period, that it just kind of looked like some of the things that happened in the case.
Detective Cox and his partner Timothy Adams collected fingerprints from the victim's car and ran it through a new database. It matched with Michael Tate. They flew to his home in Georgia, where Cox says he admitted to raping the woman in Park Hills.
We also know that the victim, while he had our victim held kidnapped, that he told her that he had committed several more rapes and that he had killed his victims.
Detective Cox and his partner think it went that far.
We believe that he is a serial rapist, and we believe that he is a serial murderer. But that's my belief.
The Park Hills victim is getting closure 4 decades later.
Gotta say, though, it's probably some of the most horrific facts I've read in a long time.
A Kenton County judge sentenced Tate to 12 years. Detective Cox says the end to this cold case means a new beginning for the victim.
She has called us a lot, and just how much she appreciates this, and how that she had lived pretty much a secluded life for all of those years, and now she's kind of coming out of her shell.
Alexa Helwig, Local 12 News.
If you think a family member might have been a victim of Michael Dean Tate, call the Boone County Sheriff's Office.